everyone knows you as like darling of Australian film and TV, and you won so many Logies and everything.
Yeah.
But I guess what people don't know is you have a huge background in dance.
Yes, I do. Yeah. I started since I danced since I was four. I did ballet. I did Giacchetti, classical ballet.
Yeah.
And I kind of stopped dancing, I suppose, doing classes when I was about 22.
Okay.
When I started.
So you
danced
for a long time.
I danced for a long time, and when I was 19, Ross Coleman, who was the main choreographer of Bandstand, and he did all the musicals and everything. He opened up a performing arts school, a la Fame. But I went to his school, and it was a school of performing arts, and I learned singing off Geraldine Turner. I learned tap off Linda Nagel, and I learned acting off George Spartels and Greg Radford, and all these great actors came in and did. So we did everything, but I also did tap modern, as it was called then, not contemporary. Modern. Oh my God. And it was lots of, everything was in parallel. That was the main difference.
Yeah.
We also did a bit of Alvin Ailey, and we did a lot of jazz, but it was like Bob Fosse jazz.
Yes.
It wasn't like, solid bowl jazz.
It was
cutting edge kind of jazz.
Yeah.
And tap. And I also learnt flamenco at that time. So I did an enormous amount of dancing from 19 to 21.
And then how'd you go into acting? You just kind of decided to focus in on that?
I was always acting, and I always wanted to act.
Yeah.
So when I was 18, I started a theatre group with a bunch of kids because we wanted to do it. We bought a name. We called ourselves Egos Unlimited, which I think most people will identify with in the arts. And we made a profit, and we put on three plays in the local hall. But I loved dancing so much, and I just knew that it would feed into the creative aspects of being a performer.
And what was your big acting break?
When I got Nonsense, it was a musical, and we toured the country for a year. So that was kind of... however, if you're a musical, you're not a straight actor, as they call it.
Right.
So I then had to break into TV. I did a mini-series, which was very big in the 80s, with Hugo Weaving and John Paulson. But that was only 6 weeks. And then after that, not long after that, I got country practice.
Oh, wow.
I was on country practice for
3 years.
How old
were you then?
I was 24. I looked about 18, but I was 24.
Okay. That must have been huge. What was it like getting the phone call?
It was amazing. I could not believe it.
Yeah.
I'd done a guestie on the show a year before, and I loved it. And that's the thing with a lot of actors. You just get guests in shows.
Yeah.
So you do a week here or 3 weeks there, and it's sort of, you get a taste, but before you know it, it's over.
Right.
And that's the life of an actor.
Yeah.
So as soon as they offered me a 3-year contract, it was like, acting could be my regular job.
Right.
And
before
I loved it.
That, you never thought it could be a possibility of being a regular job?
I wanted it to be, but it was almost like a bridge too far. And it was almost like, be careful what you dream for.
Mm-hmm.
So I was teaching dance at this time.
Okay.
I was teaching dance, teaching ballet, taking grade fours through their Giacchetti exams. And
and
I was about to sit the teacher's exam, which was really bloody hard. I'm pretty glad I didn't have to do it. Because then I was actually, thinking about I could be a ballet teacher.
Yeah.
And then do the acting jobs as they come up. But like I got country practice.
Country.
And
then,
yeah.
Wow. And then so how old were you when you first won your first Logie?
Wow, I was 25.
So not long after.
Not long after.
Wow.
I know, it was weird because I was 23 when I got the job, and I just turned 24 when I started, and I was on air for a year, and then the year after I got nominated for Best Newcomer, and it was like, bleh. And I was so excited to be nominated. I was just like, I never thought that I'd get it.
Yeah.
So I was like, I wonder who's going to get this. And when they called my name out, everyone at the table looked at me and were like, oh my God. And I was like, I have to go up? And I didn't know who to thank. I didn't know anyone's names. I was like, oh, there's that dude who does that, and he's that important person who does that. I didn't know their names. So I just churned out the names I did know and thanked the fans, because they're the ones who get you up. And then that just, it puts you on a different trajectory in a way.
Of course.
Yeah.
And from then on, that was it.
Kind of. I mean, but it's interesting, though, because you can have success, but unless you have all the ethic that goes behind what makes a success is, you're easy to work with, you're pleasant to work with, you are a problem solver, not a problem creator.
Yeah.
You think about your job, you're courteous, but you've also got to be fun. You got to know when to have fun and when to really focus. Yeah, and I really like my job, and I like the people I work with. So, you know, you need luck, you need talent, and you need hard work.
Absolutely.
And you'd be grateful for the work. I mean, you know, you may get tired, you may think, oh, but you know, there's always someone who would love to be in your shoes.
Yeah. Yeah.
So remembering that and being grateful for the opportunity is really
good. Yeah. Bad. And that's the trick to the longevity of the business.
Yeah. I think so. Yeah.
What do you think is like the best part of your job?
Being employed.
Employment
is a massive one. I mean, do you know how many people call themselves actors? And how many of those actors are actually waiting on tables?
Yeah.
And they're teaching jobs. They're teaching all their couriers, or they're working...
three other jobs.
Literally working three other jobs. Yeah. So they're trained actors, but they just don't get the opportunity to work as an actor.
Yeah.
And it's not through... Sometimes they're amazingly talented.
Yeah.
And it's just the lack of jobs is very real.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
And would you have ever gone and become a professional dancer?
No, I couldn't because I've got scoliosis.
Yeah.
So, and I've got to tell you, I loved dancing. And if I could, if I didn't have scoliosis and arthritis, which is thanks to ballet, if I didn't have those ailments, I would definitely be doing classes now.
Right.
Because it's part of my body rhythm, and it's a language I speak, you know. I think dancing is a language, and it's part of my soul, and I just love it.
Yeah.
So I do the next best thing, which is yoga and Pilates.
Yeah.
So I'm still moving my body, and I'm using the language I know.
Yeah.
Just I'm not, you know, I don't have the full vocabulary.
So did you find the ballet and the dancing really helped with...
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. It helped enormously with... coping with my scoliosis, and I think a lot of dancers actually have scoliosis.
Really?
It's really important you keep moving. But it's also helped, it's discipline. I mean, if you're an actor, your body, you know, creates the character as much as the words.
Yeah.
So it's very important that you are in control of your body.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. And you're quite a physical person.
Yes.
I mean that in a good way. Like, yes, you know, I am. Very like expressive and hugs and like hands and which is so nice.
But
to be physical would be really important for you.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I think, you know, there's so much communication is done physically.
Yeah.
And the beautiful thing about dancing is that you're telling a story with your body.
Yeah.
You know, and I think you can tell people who have danced.
Right.
No matter where they took it or how far they, how long they did it for.
Yeah.
You can tell because they have a physical confidence and an awareness about them.
Yeah.
And it's just so good for you.
Yeah, and the confidence.
And the confidence, especially for women.
The spirit that you are and everything that you do. How much was that a part of your upbringing?
Wow, I think, you know, I was the youngest woman, and my mum was trained to be a teacher, but in her day, you only really had a job until you got married.
Right.
And once you were married, you didn't have a job. But actually, mum should have been a lawyer, because she is...
super smart.
Super smart, and got an enormous amount of energy, and really needed that stimulation. So she's got the stimulation now. She does adult education. She's done it for years. But I'm really lucky that I needed to be a free spirit. And she absolutely let me be.
Yeah.
She let me be, left me to my own devices, and I created my own path a lot of the time. She just supported me and gave me advice when I needed it. But we were good friends.
Yeah, that's nice.
She just let me be.
Yeah.
And it was fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And in the industry, what would your what was the toughest thing that you came across, and what would be your advice for other women?
Well, it's really interesting. I never see myself any differently from the men I work with.
Yeah.
I never looked at myself as being, you know, they might look at me, but I never looked at myself as a woman in the business.
Yeah.
I saw myself as an actor in the business, and I demanded that I be treated accordingly.
Yeah.
I always negotiated very good money for myself because I thought, I'm worth it. After a while, I knew why they were hiring me, so I went, okay, well, that's fine, and this is...
what it is.
And I am pleasant to work with. I'll be on time, and I'll always do whatever you need me to do.
Yeah.
So you've got to know your own value as a woman. You've got to be just as happy to say yes and just as happy to say no.
Yeah.
And if people aren't giving you respect, whether it's about your gender or not, you just have to be very firm about what you will accept and what you won't accept.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I literally just view yourself as a person working with other people.
Yeah. And...
I am a feminist, proud, proudly a feminist. Have been probably since I was about five.
Yeah.
I love it. I love the word, and it's equality for all.
Yeah. And what's next for you?
I'm doing Home and Away for as long as I can, because they let me go and do plays. So next year I'm doing a play at the Ensemble Theatre. It's Barefoot in the Park. It's a comedy, and it's very funny.
Yeah.
So every second year I try and do a play.
Oh, nice.
I love it.
Yeah. So is that your medium that you love the most?
I love both. Yeah. But when you don't do theatre, you really miss it.
Right.
And you miss the audience. Yes. You know, and that's what I miss with dancing. The audience is right there.
Yeah.
Getting
that reaction straight away.
I love it. Yeah. I love it. And there's a lot of energy in the room. So, TV has its own
energy. Yeah.
Great things, and it's great. You know, and it's an awesome medium because it reaches so many people.
Yeah.
But there's something special about theatre.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, that's exciting.
Yes. Yeah.